You like jazz?
You want to listen to jazz?
Sure, why not?
Because I thought we were going to have some fun.
Hey everyone, it's Alex coming at you here for Jazz Tag 2024. Thanks, Rob, for doing it. Really enjoy the short format of this tag. Hopefully we finally get to meet up this year. Getting close a couple times last year, but so here we go. Prompt number one: show a jazz album you received as a VCLT. This is the Moon Music Universe Volume 1. See the players there, led by the great vibes player Carl Berger, Dave Holland. So this is called the Peace Church Concerts, recorded in New York at the Washington Square Church, otherwise known as the Peace Church, May 22nd, 1974. See the players there. Yeah, lovely recording with lots of space. You can really hear, you know, the church in there. There's some wordless vocals by somebody named Ing Rid. Bob Moses on percussions, Richard Tietelbaum on electronics, who of course worked with Anthony Braxton, among others. Yeah, nice, really nice record. Thank you, VCLT from Chris Cole. Really appreciate that. An album you have both stereo and mono. I don't keep multiple copies of records, and I've never had a mono cartridge or anything, but I just decided to pick a jazz record that I had in mono. So this is Mafi Fallet Sveta, or Septet, I believe. Mafi is a Turkish trumpet player, and yeah, this is one of those fantastic records that really perfectly blends, you know, traditional folk music, in this case from Sweden, with you know, jazz instrumentation and composition and improvisation. You know, I keep talking about OK Tamiz. He's here on drums. If you see anything with OK Tamiz, just buy it. The great Bernd Rosengren on flute and sax, and again, Mafi Fallet on trumpet, flugelhorn. He also plays the Indian flute. 1972, recorded in Stockholm. Fantastic record in mono. Has a really cool thing with a booklet inside as well. So, jazz album, you have the OG and the reissue. So, you know, this is a record that was reissued in 2023, of course. Danger Bali on the German MPS label. Tony Scott with here playing with Indonesian. There's Tony with fantastic Indonesian players. So I had the reissue not long ago, and I was very lucky to be able to find an original copy here a few months back that Dom alerted me to. There's some of the Indonesian players. And yeah, I don't, like I said, I don't keep duplicates, so I passed on the reissue, which, by the way, sounds fantastic and has a great booklet too, which, you know, I wish I would have kept, but, you know, there's a really nice sort of built-in booklet as well on this one. But yeah, can't recommend that one enough. A jazz album by an artist not known for being a jazz performer, so Kieran Hebden, also known as Fortet, put out these two fantastic records on Domino. I think there's only UK and Canadian pressings of these available. I think these are the Canadian ones. Mid-2000s, so 2006. So he's collaborating here with the great jazz drummer, percussionist Steve Reed. And basically what these are is Steve Reed on drums and percussion, and then Kieran Hebden, aka Fortet, just credited here with electronics. I mean, I think they're like sort of, you know, modular synthesizers. I think independent of the signal from, you know, the drum kit, so sort of improvising off of each other via electronics, and then Reed responding with his drum kit and percussion. So yeah, two volumes, both really excellent. I think the highlight arguably is the first track on this one, Morning Prayer, 6 minutes 38 seconds. But yeah, it's all good. I think they're all part of the same sessions. And actually pretty cheap still. So jazz album is initially shelved, so Eric Dolphy, Other Aspects, this came out in 1987, on Blue Note, of course. Sessions from 1962, and you might be surprised, but that's actually what we've been playing here. This is the last track on side two, called Improvisations in Turkish, which features that's Eric Dolphy on the flute, tablas by Gina Lali, and tambura with Roger Mason. One of the earliest incarnations of, I think, what we maybe misnamed, you know, spiritual jazz. I mean, to me, this is, you know, very much has that aesthetic. And I think spiritual jazz really is more nowadays really an aesthetic more than, you know, like an actual philosophy or anything like that. And yeah, I think, you know, Eastern instrumentation and this type of, you know, meditative vibe is really kind of what we nowadays, I think, refer to as spiritual jazz. But yeah, from 1960, 1962, very fascinating early example of that style. Show Jazz Album is a private pressing, so this is a Pygmy unit. This is a reissue. Originals are probably about $1,000 or so. Incredible cover art. I think the original came with a version of this cover, but in purple. But again, yeah, fantastic reissue here. These guys are from San Francisco. Unknown players to me. Just kind of, I think this is the only thing that any of these guys ever put out. Reissued a couple of years ago. I think this is, I forget what the reissue label is called. There's a couple of booklets here which actually don't provide a whole lot of information. I don't have the reissue. Oh, Holidays Records is the name, and that's the label logo. But yeah, check it out. Decidedly lo-fi affair, as it should be, with a good mysterious private press jazz records jazz record, and yeah, cool sort of artifact from the Bay Area. Pygmy unit. Sean Elton, there's an excellent introduction to free jazz, avant-garde jazz, spiritual jazz. So I, you know, just talked a little bit about kind of, you know, what I think spiritual jazz means nowadays. But yeah, this is sort of an underappreciated record that sort of touches on kind of at least two of the three, you know, subgenres there, avant-garde and spiritual jazz. This is a very ambitious recording from the trumpet player Clifford Thornton, a guy that would also record a great deal in Europe for different European labels. Is on the JC OA label, and as such, you know, remains kind of pretty cheap and you know, still available. This is a large ensemble, and the philosophy of this recording, as you can tell just from the music and certainly from the liner notes, you know, it's really a trip through sort of, you know, the origins of jazz, you know, from the Middle East, from North Africa, to Jamaica, to Cuba, to the Afro-Cuban and you know, African, to North America and you know, the African-American tradition and so on, you know, and specifically, of course, in Harlem. So you get everything here, and at the same time it's a great introduction because it's not completely untethered. It's definitely composition based, and you know, there are a couple of saxophones here, but they're, you know, again very much in the background, you know, and no slouches either. It's Stuart Redman and Carlos Ward. But then you also have Ted Daniel on trumpet, you have Leo Smith on trumpet, you have Marvin Peterson on trumpet, and of course Clifford Thornton, who plays the cornet. And you also have basically like, you know, 10 African percussion players that really provide, you know, great texture as you kind of take this, you know, journey through, you know, again from like North Africa to the Caribbean and into the into North America. Yeah, great record, worth seeking out. Jazz album is an example of cheap heat. I mean, obviously, you know, cheap heat, well, kind of always think of like sort of funkier things, or, you know, fire music or something. Yeah, this is a decidedly not fiery and very sort of spacious. Yeah, very much in the avant-garde mode, I would say. Very cheap, great cover, and yeah, players I'm not real familiar with, but yeah, great instrumentation here: marimba, harp, guitar, clarinet, bassoon, flute. So, you know, very much sort of like a chamber jazz affair. It's also got some, there's a three women and yeah, sorry, yeah, three women doing some wordless vocals as well. So yeah, if you're interested in something a little bit weird, a little bit spacious, a little bit mysterious, The Ghost Opera, I don't even have a year. And actually, I think this is also a, yeah, also a San Francisco musician type thing. So a jazz album you're looking forward to being reissued in 2024. I mean, really, anything by the label Gotta Groove out of, where are they? I think Cleveland, in Ohio. And they've been, they've had two of the best reissues, I think, of the last 10 years on the jazz side, in my opinion. Yeah, Cleveland, Ohio. I mean, they put out both of these. I didn't buy this reissue, and this is an original copy, but I know from everybody that got the reissue for Abdul with Dudes by myself, they did an excellent job. You know, I know that there were some issues with the tape that they had to sort of correct, but by all accounts, they did a great job. And then, of course, you know, Black Unity Trio, also featuring Abdul Wadud, and also from that Ohio jazz scene from the mid-70s, another fantastic reissue. So yeah, look forward. I don't know off the top of my head of any sort of unreleased Ohio, you know, great jazz records, but yeah, hopefully they put out something great in 2024. And then finally, Jazz Alone, which you consider to be a holy grail that you picked up. So this just came in, I think last Friday. Take out of the sleeve here. So another one that was reissued, I think, in 2024. So this is Our Meaning and Our Feelings from Michel Portal, fantastic saxophonist from France, here with Joachim Kuhn on a number of different instruments: piano, alto, chennai, antelope horn, steel drum, and percussions. J.F. Jenny Clark, great French bassist. Aldo Romano, fantastic drummer. And Jacques Thelot, so obviously a very percussion heavy. And yeah, another one of those sort of early, you know, examples is from 1969. You know, that's really bringing in the, you know, non-Western influences, you know, that came to sort of define, you know, spiritual jazz. A fantastic track here called Dear Old Morocco on side one. That's one of the highlights here. featuring what I think is like a Turkish flute. So yeah, I got this. This is one that I talked about in a couple of streams. I got through a French auction house for a pretty fair price, and yeah, took a while to get it here from France, but yeah, great to have this. And this actually is a copy from, looks like it's a library in Monte Carlo of all places. So there's like kind of the library card, and it's got that seal from the Discothèque de Radio Monte Carlo. So on the great Pathé Marconi label. That's my tag. Take care, bye.